Hi guys.
Welcome back to the Los Angeles Couple Podcast.
We missed you.
That's right. So today we're going to talk about Top Gun.
Dun, 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 dun.
We saw it on Memorial Day.
Perfect movie for American holidays.
Right, very American of us. And we have some thoughts.
So first of all, the pick was perfect for the day. And I think the release time for this movie is pretty fantastic because it's between Memorial Day and the 4th of July. So they're going to get a lot of views, a lot of patriotic people watching. And that's Dante even knows like how many, but it was like
it was
a record.
A huge weekend. Tom Cruise's first $100 million plus opening, I heard.
$100 million.
Which is pretty standard nowadays. But you got to remember, Tom Cruise's heyday was back in the 80s and 90s when you didn't have $100 million openings. So like the biggest opening was like $20 million or something like that.
Is it because of the inflation? I think like because movie tickets are so, it's so expensive.
I don't know if this is the most tickets he's ever sold in an opening weekend or if it's just the highest dollar amount because of inflation. But either way, it was a big, big weekend. He's very happy.
I'm happy for him. I think Tom Cruise is very charismatic, one of America's A-listers. Like, he's one of the last few movie stars. Like, I think, like, Tom Cruise, Brad Pitt, Angelina Jolie, Julia Roberts, Clooney, those people are going to be our last A-listers. And I think, like, the movie, DiCaprio as well. There's other people as well. The list is a little, it's not as short as I said, but I'm saying, like, he's one of America's last big movie stars. And I think that's something to celebrate, that he's putting up a movie at his age that in that level.
Yeah, I will say you can tell he really cares about making movies for the big screen. He wants them to be exciting. I appreciate that he almost exclusively utilizes real airplanes and real set pieces. He doesn't just cut corners and go with CGI because the eye can tell. It's much better. The same reason Jurassic Park still holds up so well is because there was so much
animatronics
and puppets and all that stuff. So that's good. He really cares. You got to respect that. He loves movies. He loves being a movie star. But yeah, it did feel like an old time movie from different age.
Yeah, exactly. But I think that kind of adds up to the nostalgia of the time. And I think that a lot of people watching that movie, there are people that were younger. Because that movie came out like we were coming out to the world when that movie came out. But the thing is, like, it's crazy. Like, even though, like, later in life I watched that movie that was like on TV or for rental. And I felt like some type of nostalgia watching. And There's something interesting. I think like back in the day, movies were very centric into America way of life, teamwork, and military pride. And it's something that I feel like maybe with the woke community and it's something that kind of faded away a little bit.
A lot of conservatives online are saying like, see Hollywood, America wants feel good movies about their country. Not the woke stuff, but they might be right because the movie had a major opening.
Yeah.
And it's getting some pretty good reviews. I never saw the first Top Gun movie.
You should watch it.
I always looked at it as a white movie. A movie for white people and white culture. And, you know, a lot of people think, despite popular opinion, I'm actually not white. I'm Italian. Which may not seem like much of a distinction, but culturally there is. I don't go snowboarding. I don't play polo.
I go ski.
Well, you're white.
I'm like Italian.
You know, nothing against that stuff. It's just not like it didn't appeal to me in like movies like Top Gun or A Few Good Men. I'm sure they're good, but I didn't identify with that. So I never saw the original Top Gun. But this one, okay. Tom Cruise really wants us to go see it. We checked it out. I enjoyed it.
He called us. He called us in the morning of Memorial Day.
Well, no, he
did. He said, hey, Dante and Evie, I would love to for you guys to see my movie.
Yeah. He did do a little, before the movie, he has a little video clip where he's like, thanks. we made this movie for you and we use real planes and blah, blah, blah. Like,
oh my God. Really, that's so cool. It was nice. And I thought that was very thoughtful. I enjoy seeing Tom saying, thank you for seeing this movie. We put a lot of love and effort in it. And you can see that he did. You can see it that he really did.
You know, one thing that I liked about it was, getting back to the music, they kept the kind of cheesy, dated sounding 80s electric guitar music.
But that added to it.
And it added to it because we know the original was like one of the seminal movies of the 1980s. And what I hate to see these days is when they'll make a movie, like they got this Elvis movie coming out.
I can't wait to see it.
They've got all these young artists reinterpreting songs for the modern.
I wish to promote you, Mr. Preston.
And I get that people who make movies want to make money on them and they want young people to come. So they're trying to appeal to them.
But we went to Top Gun.
It cheapens it for me.
Yeah.
When they put modern music juxtaposed alongside historical
characters like Elvis
or you know, like it's just so stupid. There was a movie that came out a few years ago with Josh Brolin and some other guys. It took place in the 30s and then everyone's got their fedoras. It's about like zoot suits or some shit.
Okay.
And they're playing just music that had no connection to that era.
Yeah,
it sucks. So I appreciated that they kept the 80s music.
Me too. And I think it must be, I haven't read much about it yet, or I haven't seen many interviews about it yet. But I wonder if like Tom really wanted to kind of like keep the music, because it's such a staple for that movie to have that kind of that guitar thing. And I think added to it, I agree with Dante completely. I think that movies should kind of hold on their artistic style by keeping up the music, because I think especially if it's a remake or if it's a movie like regarding Elvis Presley, it's nice to have Elvis Presley playing in the movie or music at the time to kind of bring you kind of like more of the feel and the spirit of it, because our memories are not only like stuff that you look or you smell, it's also like the soundtrack of the time. Yeah. You can be teleported to that time if they really keep it real and give you a sense of the, I don't know, there's something about the music that kind of brings you to that time. Like for example, Dante and I are driving sometimes by Sunset Boulevard going from Palisades or Malibu, and he puts like the Beatles or put some like Beach Boys or whatever. It just puts you, it almost feels like we're time traveling.
You set the theme.
Yeah.
Our life is a movie. You know, speaking of
all our lives are, and we encourage you guys, the Los Angeles Couple fans, to really kind of like think of your life as a movie and think about the soundtrack that you want for each moment and really be thoughtful of it. And it's kind of cool.
Speaking of the movie and the music, so the original had the big hit, Take My Breath Away. And then in this one, they had Lady Gaga come in and make a whole new song called Hold My Hand. Promise me, just hold my hand. They should have just had Lady Gaga re-record Take My Breath Away. This new song is nothing compared to the, now I sound like I'm a big defender of Take My Breath Away. I'm not. I'm really not that even attached to
you
that song.
You should put
song.
A little clip of like the take when you Mocha fall in love with
you. But like this Lady Gaga song is just overdone, and I like Lady Gaga.
I like Gaga too.
But it just doesn't compare. She should have just re-recorded it. Just fully embrace the 80s vibe. This new
she
song
she would totally
sucks.
Go bananas. She have like the weaves and she kind of will get into the mood.
Yeah, it's not memorable. I can't even remember how it goes right now. We just saw the movie 2 days ago.
I don't remember much of the song, but I remember the guitar and then they kept the original. But let me say something. Let's go about Tom. So first of all, he is in fantastic shape. And I think that whatever, let's say, upkeeps that he's been doing to maintain his image, it works. I mean, maybe they might be using some filters on the cameras, because they do that for these days, like for even reality shows, by the way, they record them and they have like a software that's very advanced that they cannot connect.
But I've seen pictures of him at Cannes and other film premieres lately, and he looks fantastic.
He looks pretty good. I think like he probably has a very restrict diet and exercise and routine. And I think it's working. He looks fantastic. His teeth looks great. His body looks great. His voice still the same, which is kind of interesting because you see actors over the time, even like Brad Pitt, it changes, right? The voice gets different as you age. But Tom was able to hold him to his voice. He sounds, if not the exact same, he sounds exactly the same as when he was doing his first movies.
We happened to see a MiG-28 do a 4G negative dive.
I have to admit, I wasn't expecting an invitation back.
Back in the day.
I have some thoughts about this subject. Tom Cruise looks great.
That's what I want.
He does.
He's almost 60. But
looks 40.
To me, there's a certain point, there's a threshold you cross, and he, in my opinion, has crossed it, where it becomes disturbing that you still look this good at that age, and desperate that you're still trying so hard. And I say the same thing about Jennifer Lopez.
Or Nicole Kidman.
Like, less Nicole Kidman, but Jennifer Lopez too. She's always dressing so young, and she's obsessed with her fitness. You know, it kind of goes in cycles. You come out hot and young. Everyone thinks you look great. Then 10 to 15 years later, they check in on you, and they're like, wow, still in shape. Hasn't lost it. Great. Amazing. You see articles like, wow, still looking fabulous and fit at like 45. Then at 50, oh my God, still looks incredible. After that, if you're still holding on, you are desperate.
Why?
Almost pathetic. Because there's something to be said about nobly aging and looking good for your age. Now, looking good for your age doesn't mean trying to look 40 years younger. It just means looking like a gentleman, looking refined, you know, let a little gray come in.
Nothing.
It messes with my mind that Tom Cruise is out there with fully brown hair, and he has a good dye job too, and his face looks so young. I don't know if he has a plastic surgeon or what, or fillers.
He does.
He doesn't have that weird,
he does.
Jocelyn Wildenstein face.
Actually, there's like a picture of him in a Dodgers game like last year. He had his face looks really fat.
I remember
and,
that.
And it's because, so he actually did a lot of plastic surgery. I recommend a YouTuber called Lori Hill. She talks about plastic surgery, and she posted 9 days ago about Tom Cruise and his plastic surgery journey. She kind of talks for him from like teenager years all the way to what he looks now. So apparently he did had a lot of work done. He had fat transfer, liposucked from his body and transferred to his face. And when you do that, you had to leave the fat be in the face to settle. And then he kind of like, they removed in the parts they're not supposed to be. So keeps the face really young. And he has other treatments.
It's just,
so when he was at the Dodgers game, his face looks really fat. He just had the fat transfer. And now once settles, and then they adjust, they take the fat away in places they're not supposed to be.
He looks amazing. Shouldn't have gone to that Dodger game. We wouldn't be on to him.
But we're organized.
The thing is, though, there's an uncanny.
But it's a human thing. He's going to upkeep.
There's an uncanny valley element to this, where you see him and you're like, that's not, Tom Cruise should not look like that. What's he going to look like at 70 or 80? Is he going to look 45? Like, just let yourself experience the different ages of man. And J-Lo, I say it to you too. Stop this obsession. You're going to all end up like Madonna, where you're pathetically doing stunts trying to look so young. Like, just age gracefully. Madonna should have done what Lady Gaga did. Lady Gaga saw that people weren't as into her new music, her pop music anymore. She pivoted and aged herself music-wise by 50 years and started going on a tour with Tony Bennett. It worked out great.
Stepping out with my baby.
Speaking of Tony Bennett,
because she's
Miles
Italian.
Teller
she's...
in this movie looks just like Tony Bennett now. That guy has an old man's face on a young man's body. He looks good. His skin is smooth, but like he really gives me like waiting to age.
I don't think so. I think all the gentlemen in the movie look in fantastic shape. There was a scene of all the guys running on the beach without shirts. They all look super in shape. They all look great. I was impressed at how many like good looking, like how did you put like a casting for this? They're like, must be really, really hot or willing to get hot. And I noticed they were spray tanned. I noticed they work out. Probably Tom was like, you guys got to get into my regimen, which I support. Yeah. And by the way, I disagree with Dante completely in that. I think that you should try to, if you have the means and the discipline and you wanted to hold on into your youth as much as you can, I think that's something that if you had the means, you should do it. But if you're a person that don't have the means, if you don't have the discipline and you think you're going to put a lot of fillers, you're going to end looking like an old tiger.
It goes bad for most people.
Kind of like those women, or even Courtney Cox when she did a lot of fillers, a lot of other actresses as well. And, you know, they kind of look like they have like the puffy face. But
I'm starting to worry about Cardi B, by the way. Like, I like Cardi B.
She looks weird.
But she's doing too much too early. She's going to look like that Jocelyn Wildenstein, the Catwoman, in about 10 years if she doesn't slow down.
She already started looking like that. But the thing is, I think that plastic surgery, it sometimes is addictive. We saw Michael Jackson. We saw Joan Rivers. Rest in peace. I love Joan Rivers, by the way. But I think like Tom Cruise and Jennifer Lopez, I think they've been doing very minimalistic procedures along the years that kind of helped them to upkeep. But yes, he had the fat transfer at the Dodgers game. Looks kind of shocking. Yeah. He had a couple jaw lines and implants done in his face or whatever. But I think like in my opinion, he looks great, and I think that he's adding to his image. I would not want to see. Would you want to see the movie if he looked like how he looked at the Dodgers?
I wouldn't. No! If he showed up with a big puffy face, no. But
or old.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind if Tom Cruise's character had a little gray.
But he's a hunk. He's a hunk. It's not supposed to be like a Clint Eastwood. He's the handsome guy.
Except it's been 35 years since the original. It's never addressed in the film why this guy, who's a pilot, who flies under very stressful situations, you know, going to Mach 10, somehow has not aged a day from the original. Maybe there's a backstory that they didn't show in the movie, but like some kind of military experiment they did on this guy. But it's never addressed, and it's disturbing to me. So one other thing I want to bring up. In the original movie, Kelly McGillis was the actress playing Tom Cruise's love interest.
She's in a meme with them. There's a meme of them together saying how they didn't. She didn't age gracefully.
Why she's not in it. And she herself has come out and said, because I'm old and fat and I look age appropriate. And that's not what they wanted for the movie. And, you know, honestly, that's fine. I think it's kind of horse shit that people are looking at her and being like, look at you compared to Tom. Tom had a way more successful career. He has a lot more money. He has Scientology slaves who are helping him.
It's about the discipline.
And also, she might just be like, hey, you know what? I don't care that much.
Bad jeans. She probably has bad jeans. But this is
the point I'm making. I think it's unfair for people to be looking at her and trying to like shame her for her
look. Nobody's shaming her.
Yeah, they are. People online are just like, oh my God.
Well, she didn't take care of herself.
Who looks her, how she looks compared to him?
I agree with the internet.
I think she just lived a normal life. It's not that she didn't take care of herself. It's just people.
Take care of herself.
There is a sickness to wanting to hold on that tightly to youth that you go to the obsessive lengths that Tom Cruise and Jennifer Lopez go to.
I would do it too.
I want to tell them, just go eat a fucking full buffet. Go drink. Go do some drugs. Go have some fun in your life before it's all over.
Shit.
No. You don't have to do it to excess, but like at a certain point, Tom Cruise is 60. You can let go.
No.
All right. Start playing some age appropriate roles.
Tom, keep it up. You look amazing. I love you, Tom. Woo! And J Lo.
He's taking roles away from age-appropriate actors. That should be a 40-year-old in Top Gun or the new Mission Impossible.
I don't want to see anyone else. I went to see that movie. When I entered the movie, I said to the movie ticket guy that was in the entrance, I said, I'm here because I have a date with Tom. And he's like, oh, Thomas Cruise? I was like, yeah, he's waiting for me. He's like, go ahead. Thomas is waiting for you. Room whatever. Room, I don't know, six or seven, whatever. Seven. Room seven. I was just like, okay, let's go. We went there. Anyways, What I'm trying to say is that I would not watch this movie if it wasn't for Tom Cruise. I'm happy that he was there. And the woman that also played his love interest, she looked amazing for her age, too. Still,
Jennifer Connelly.
Jennifer Connelly looks so good for her age. I think that she's also doing a great job like Tom Cruise and J-Lo. She's keeping up pretty well. She's healthy. And she looked fantastic. And I'm happy. I'm happy to see that, you know, gives you hope that you don't have to look like an old rag when you're old. Like, I think, like, people that just age and allow themselves to age, it's your choice. But I don't want to look like that. I'm going to be like Tom Cruise and J-Lo. I'm going to keep up my workout. I'm going to continue eating healthy. Yes, on vacation or on occasion, I'm going to eat stuff that's not good for me. But most of the time, I enjoy the process of working out. I enjoy the process of getting my hair done. I enjoy the process of getting my nails done. I enjoy even the process of getting Botox done in my forehead. So, no. I'm not going to age gracefully with like a graceful limit. Sorry, I'm not going to just let myself age. I'm going to age gracefully. And that's my choice and it's their choice. And I respect and I work really hard and I have the means to continue maintaining myself. And that's what I'm going to do. Okay?
That's fine. I'm just saying you can age gracefully, but look your age.
No.
Let's get back to the movie.
I love the movie.
Yeah, it was good. You know what? This is what my new way of reviewing movies is. Is it what I expected? Did I get what I expected out of
it?
Yes. So I enjoyed it.
Americana.
Every movie doesn't have to change cinema and make a statement about our society and all that bullshit. There's too much other media now for movies to have that much importance. Just be happy when you pay for a movie and you go and sit through it and you're not disappointed at the end.
I love that the movie didn't have too much of explicit violence. I love that was action without explicit violence. I didn't saw some guy with his like leg cut in half and spilling blood on my face.
Private Ryan.
No. It was kind of like almost like typical 80s, appropriate. Even the lovemaking scene was super appropriate. It was just like it felt like appropriate.
It was almost cheesy, but
it was appropriate.
It was appropriate.
I don't know. It was good. I like that. I miss that kind of like that politeness. And I don't know. There's something about Tom Cruise and it.
Good movie. Get out and see it if you're interested, if you're looking for something.
Yes. Well, thank you. Let us know what you think about plastic surgery, Tom Cruise. I think he looks amazing. Like, subscribe, and support the channel. We have an Instagram page. We are in, where are
Twitter,
we?
Twitter, TikTok,
Podcasts, YouTube, Spotify,
podcast, Apple Podcasts, Spotify.
We are everywhere.
Support it, subscribe everywhere, please, for the love of God.
Yes. And we are looking forward to talk to you guys in the next video. Stay connected. Dun, 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 dun. Don't.